I will be using Adobe After Effects for this demonstration, and you can download all the assets, all the files that I will be using here in the link in the description below. First of all, I will be starting with the scene with a cat. So I'll drag it here directly, then go to Edit, Duplicate, and for the top layer, go select Pen Tool and make a rough selection of the cat. Okay, once you made a selection, let's hide the bottom layer. By having the top layer selected, let's press letter F for mask feather, and let's increase just a bit. Okay, so the edges are more soft, and now you will see how easy and fast this animation is. So here in the toolbar, we select puppet position pin tool. If you don't see it, left click and hold it, and you will see it. It's the first option. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna select this part, because I believe this part that should be lifting up and down while the cat is breathing. So we select this part first, and by default, if you move it, it moves all the cat. To avoid moving all the cat, we have to set anchor points. So in this case, I will add a few more pins like that. And we can grab again the top pin and move it up and down to see how the cat is moving already. Okay, it's way too much. So I will add perhaps one more pin here in the head and perhaps one more pin here. Let's grab it again. Let's add maybe one more pin. Okay, I like it. By having this layer selected, let's go to Effect, Puppet, Mesh, Deform. Make sure you have mesh selected and press on the pin that we should animate. So press it, it gets revealed here. Let's expand it. And by default, you already have a keyframe added. So what we have to do, we move perhaps 2.5 seconds. And what I'm gonna do, I will grab it and move it up ever so little. I move it and you can see that keyframe is added already. And if you move the time indicator, you will see how animation is happening. Then I will move the time indicator to 5 seconds. I select the first keyframe, go to Edit, Copy, and Edit, Paste. And we have an added keyframe already. To smooth out the animation, select all, right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease. And here you go. To make it continuously loop every 5 seconds, hold Alt button, press again on a keyframe. Then you're gonna get some text here. Let's delete it. And then write loop, and you have already option loop out with parentheses. Select, then add quotes and add cycle and press enter. If you play now, you can see every 5 seconds, it will loop again. Now reveal the background. As you can see, the animation there looks really good. To complement, you can add any fireplace. In my case, I will use the fireplace footage from the Pixabay. I will scale it, hold shift button. Scale it equally. Let's place it somewhere like that. Mode, screen, right? Then go to pen tool, create a mask. Okay, let's go to mask feather and let's increase it to soften the edges. And then because, as you can see, the background is blurry because of the camera lens blur, we can match that by going to effect, blur, camera lens blur, and increase the number that in your opinion it matches the best. And here you go. And then we will create another scene. So you have the image, right click, new comp from selection, and for this we're gonna use exactly the same technique. We go to edit, duplicate, and with a pen tool, and we make a selection of this person. Okay, I have my selection. I will hide the background. Press letter F to relieve feather. Let's add a touch. Okay, and we're gonna use the same technique with a puppet position pin tool. I believe this part should be lifting up while she breathes. Then I will add anchor points that I don't want to be moved. Okay. I like it. Press letter U, you will get all the keyframes that has been added. And by having mesh selected, select the pin which we want to animate, and it gets revealed. It is here, puppet pin number one, and we move 2.5 seconds. If you want to make it faster, you can perhaps choose 1.5 seconds. It really depends on your style. So I will move slightly up. I will preview it. All right, 5 seconds, copy, paste, select all, right click, keyframe assistant, easy ease. After 5 seconds, the animation does not continue anymore. Just like before, hold Alt button, press on a keyframe, loop, select loop out with parentheses, 2 quotation marks, cycle, and that's all. And we have the animation happening. Then we can relieve the background. And here is how it's looking. To complement this scene, I might as well add a slight animation to the curtains. For that, I will duplicate the background, and this middle one, I will select the curtains. If you press here, you will have only curtains revealed. And on the curtains, go to Effect, Distort, Turbulent Displace. And as you can see, you can clearly see where we're going with this. Now it's way too extreme right now. You can fix that. Ideally for me, what worked, I put 3 in the amount and size 150. Then let's add a keyframe for evolution here at the very beginning. Then I'll take time indicator to the very back. You can add any number you want. For me, 5 was working the best. Here you go. Now, if you move time indicator at the very end, you will see that we have a jump between the end and the beginning. To fix that, we go to evolution options and add cycle evolution. And if you play right now, we don't have any jump and it's looping seamlessly. Then press here to reveal all the other backgrounds. Then I have a couple more animations created for you, such as particles that you just drag and drop. Set mouse mode to screen and it fits perfectly. Then I have created a couple of stars for you. And here what we have to do is duplicate 2 times, duplicate and duplicate again, each duplicate for one of those stars. So what we do, we select the first one and then create a mask for this. Then select the second one, create a mask, and then select the last one, create a mask. And this way we have, and this way with one footage, we've created 3 stars that we can distribute all over the sky. We select all 3 of them, put the screen mode, and then all you have to do, press letter S to reveal scale and scale it down. Let's place it. Let's take another one, scale. Select one of them. Let's duplicate again. Create as many as you want and place wherever you want. If you play it, you will see that all of them are flickering in different intervals. And perhaps one more effect I will add, it is glow effect. I'll set it to screen. Press letter S to reduce the scale and add it on these flowers. And then I will duplicate 2 more times, put it here, and then put it here. Here is the final result.